Welcome friends to my channel Smart Learning Academy. In this video tutorial, I am going to discuss about the classification of amino acid and basic structure of all standard amino acids. Okay, so let's start the classification of amino acid. Why we need to classify the amino acid? Because in the nature there is a different type of amino acid. Like we can classify the amino acid on the basis of their R group. Some are aliphatic, some are aromatic, some are hydroxyl group, some contains amino group, some contains acidic group. We can classify also on the basis of their requirement, that is, some are essential, some are non-essential, and some are semi-essential. We can classify on the basis of their polar group, that is, some are non-polar, some are polar but charged, some are polar but non-charged. So we can see the various classification of amino acid. Let's see the classification of amino acid on the basis of various things. So just focus on the whiteboard. I will tell you, and I will tell you some short tricks how to remember the various classification of amino acids. So here is the amino acid. We can classify on the basis of R group, on the basis of R group. If we classify on the basis of R group, then different type of amino acid, that is aliphatic. Okay, aliphatic amino acid. Second group is aromatic. Third is hydroxyl group. Fourth is sulfur containing. Okay, fifth is imino group. Sixth is amino group, and the seventh is carboxylic group. When there is aliphatic amino acid, glycine, valine, alanine, leucine, isoleucine. Okay, aromatic, phenylalanine, tyrosine, tryptophan. Okay, then hydroxyl, there is a serine and threonine. What are the amino acid that contains the sulfur? That is cysteine and methionine. Amino group, there is only one amino acid in the amino classification, that is proline, because all the amino acid contains the primary amine, but this amino acid proline has the exception that contains the secondary amine, which included in the imino group. In the amino group, three amino acids are there: lysine, arginine and histidine. For the carboxylic group, aspartate and glutamate. One classification is left, that is known as amide group. Two amino acids are there in amide group: asparagine and glutamine. So these are the standard amino acid, 20 standard amino acid classified on the basis of R group. When we classify the amino acid on the basis of requirement, so when we classify on the basis of requirement, then this is classified into three parts. The first one is essential, second one is semi-essential, and the third one is non-essential. So these three classifications is done on the basis of requirement. So which are the amino acid that included in essential? I will tell you one quote that is very important. LT. P is not here proline, and T is not here tyrosine. So this is the code, very important, LTLT. V for valine, I for isoleucine, M for methionine, P for phenylalanine, L for leucine, T for tryptophan, L for lysine, T for threonine. P for here not is proline and T is not tyrosine here. So what are the semi-essential? Only two amino acids. First one is arginine and second one is a histidine. So the rest amino acid is non-essential. What are the rest? A3, G3, PCS, T. Okay, A3, G3, PCS test. What is T here? T is a tyrosine, P is a proline, C is a cysteine, S is a serine, and G3, glycine, glutamate, and glutamine. Here A, alanine, aspartate, and asparagine. So this is the classification of amino acid on the basis of requirement. When we classify on the basis of polar nature, on the basis of polarity, so it may be non-polar. When it can be polar, if it is a polar, it may be uncharged, and if it is a polar, then it can be also charged. So what are the amino acid which is non-polar in nature? All the aliphatic amino acid is non-polar. So aliphatic plus methionine plus phenylalanine, proline and tryptophan. So aliphatic amino acid, all aliphatic, methionine, phenylalanine, proline and tryptophan, these are the non-polar amino acids. What are the polar amino acid but uncharged? The first one is cysteine, serine, threonine, asparagine and glutamine. These are the amino acid having the polarity in nature, but they are uncharged amino acid. What are the amino acid having the polar nature, but they are charged? So these are the aspartate, glutamate, histidine, lysine and arginine. These are the acidic amino acid, these are the basic amino acid. So this is the three basic classification of amino acid on the basis of various parameters. First one is R group, second one is requirement, third is the polarity. The fourth classification of amino acid is done on the basis of standard nature. If it is done, that is standard or non-standard. There are 20 standard amino acid I told you in the first class, and there is two non-standard amino acid, that is selenocysteine and pyrrolysine. Okay, the fifth type of classification of amino acid on the basis the precursor where it can be used. When there is a carbohydrate molecule, it can be utilized for the energy generation. After carbohydrate, the fats are used for the energy generation. When there is no fat is also available, then protein is utilized for the energy generation. So when amino acids are used for the energy generation, then basically for the proteins, when proteins goes for the energy generation, it degraded into the amino acids. And amino acid goes for the two direction. One, directly amino acid goes for the glucose formation. And the second form is, it forms acetyl CoA and ultimately forms the ketone bodies. So it can form the glucose, that is endogenic in nature, either it can form the ketone bodies. So this is the precursor. What is the nature of precursor of amino acid? It can be glucogenic or it can be ketogenic or it can be both. So let's see, classify the amino acid on the basis of precursor. In this year 2018 June of examination, one question is asked, what are the amino acid which is glucogenic and ketogenic both in nature? So there is the answer. I will tell you the ketogenic. The first classification is glucogenic. Second one is ketogenic. And the third one is glucoketogenic. Okay. So for the ketogenic amino acid, only two amino acids are there for the ketogenic amino acid. The code for the ketogenic amino acid is L2, or you can say LL, basically leucine and lysine. Okay. And for the glucoketogenic type of classification, there is also a code. What is, you can you know the term IP3G. Okay. So here just change the term IP3T. IP3T, expand 3T ko. 3T ko aap expand kariye. 1T, 2T and 3T. Here is I is for isoleucine, P for phenyl alanine, T for the tyrosine, T for the threonine and this T for the tryptophan. So this is the code for the glucoketogenic. And the option for this, that question of CSIR, this isoleucine and phenylalanine was the answer for that question. And the rest of amino acid except that LL and IP3T are the glucogenic in nature. So this is overall classification of amino acid on the basis of various parameters. You will never find this classification in any type of book. So please learn about the classification and remember the amino acid in various classification. Like in this CSIR examination, they ask for the glucoketogenic, and maybe in the next part they ask for the glucogenic standard amino acid or polar amino acid, or what kind of amino acid, you don't know. So remember all the amino acid. Hope you like my video. Thank you for watching this video. Thank you very much.